Hey Shopify users, in this video I'm going to show you how you can manually add DNS records to your Shopify registered domain to get your G Suite email working. So this is my second video on this topic. In that video it was slightly different flow. You basically create your G Suite account and G Suite / Google. They make our lives easier. They make us add this record to Shopify. And with that, they also add these other records that are needed for the email to work. So what I'm referring to is when you're setting up your G Suite, you end up on this page. And the first thing you do is click on this protect link. And what that does is it gives you a record that you need to add to Shopify. Once you add that record, along with it, it adds some more records and gets your email working. Now, for some reason, say you have verified your email and it just did not add the records for you, what you can do is go into Shopify and you will go into settings and then domains, and then go to your main domain, and then on the top you see these domain settings, edit DNS settings, and down here you are seeing all these records. And then in here you should see some like four records or so, or something for Gmail. And if you're not seeing those, that means you don't have those records. And what you need to do is go to this Google Workspace setup page, which is the one I showed you earlier. So here it's like this. So mine, this, I had added that record in the past and then ended up deleting those records for this video. So right now it shows that my domain is protected, but my Gmail is not working. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go through these steps to get this working again. So for some reason, if you don't have the records, you can follow these steps so your Gmail starts to work. Now click on this link right here. It's gonna say blah blah blah, read through it. I'm ready to activate Gmail. And next step here. Now earlier, remember, it was giving us a record to verify. My domain's already verified. It's not gonna show me that. So it's gonna probably take me to rest of the steps to show me those records so I can add them to Shopify. So go to step two and look at that. Add Google MX records. Review your existing DNS records and delete any non-Google MX records. And what this means is we have to go to Shopify. And as you see down here, this here. So you might have this record. This record you will have to delete. You see this MX dot? So this is the type of record. And that's what Google is saying. You need to delete this. So I am gonna go ahead in here and I am going to remove this. So now you can see we have the CNAME TXT, but we don't have any other MX records. Those MX records are related to your email. So let's go back to here. And what we are going to do is write down here, create a DNS record like the one shown in this example. So right here, what we are going to do is copy this. You click in there and then and it gets copied. And we need to go back to Shopify. And right here, you're going to do add custom record. And you can see all these types, which one we want to add. We want to add MX record. This is related to email. And here, so what you just copied, post that in here, control V to paste it, and then priority and name. So if you go back, it tells us the priority is one, host is going to be at TTL, this value, I believe it's not there. So we're just going to do priority one, host at. So right here. It shows that at sign, but it's not in there. You need to type that in, and then priority one, and then confirm. All right, so there you go. We have added one of these records. Now, if you go back, there is actually more records that we need to add right here. So you're gonna see they're very similar. The only difference is this 1, 2, 3, 4. So you could just copy this and then just remember there's 2 or 5, then there's 2 with 10. So I'm gonna go back again here. I'm gonna add a custom MX record, type at, paste that in here, make sure this is 1, priority here, I'm gonna do 5, and then confirm. Now, I'm not gonna even go back because I already know what the other record is. I'm gonna do this again, at sign, I'm going to paste that in here, and then I'm gonna just change this to 2. And then here it was 5. It's up to you. You don't feel comfortable, you can just one by one take your time, go copy and come back here and paste them. And you know, just be very careful, don't mess up those values. At the end you can always double check. So confirm. Now let's see, we have this one, we have 2 with 5, 1, 2. Let's go check here. We have 2 with 5. These two are left with these values. So I'm going to copy this one, go back again, and then back to the MX record, at, paste the value, and this is going to be 10. This is 3 here, so next one is going to be 4. So I'm going to go back up here, MX record again, and at, paste this, I'm going to change this to 4, and then this value priority was 10. Confirm. All right, so now let's double check, right? So go back here, it wanted us to add this record, and then it wanted us to add these records, and next, once you've added all 5 MX records, it should look similar to this. So does ours look similar to this? Let's check all this. So the first one is ASPMX, and then they're alt 1 alt 2 3 4. So right here, so there is this ASPMX, and then there's alt 1.ASPMX. Let's 1 2 3 4, let's see, and these are 2 5s, these are 2 10s. So just make sure, you know, double check, make sure they all match these values here. After that, next, right here, you see down here it says click this activate Gmail, and I'm going to do this. Now right now it's checking at Shopify to see if those records are all there, everything is good. There you go, you can see this is great job, MX records are updated, finish. And there you go, it's saying Gmail is activated for pets, my domain for petscenes.com. So this is all that should be needed to get your email working. Now do make sure that you are still not forwarding your email. So in domains right around here, email forwarding, make sure you don't have these forwards. So like this one here I have, I'm just going to delete this, and that's it right here. See, it's already saying this G Suite is set up. You can just change it. Otherwise, you would see something like set up third-party email hosting, something like that. But this is a good sign. And there's one last thing I wanted to tell you, was that if you want your emails to not end up in your customer's spam folder, there is one more record you can add here. And that record is, you will go in here. Now this time you're going to add a TXT record, and here same thing, add an at sign, and here I am going to paste this record. So I will leave this in the description also, but this is the value. So With this, your emails will not end up in the spam folder of your customers. So this is very important, and I suggest you to add this. And so that's it. That's all you should need to get your email working. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.